Hi guys, today we're going to be cooking snowshoe hare using Stone Age methods. Keep watching.
I'm just going to use dry grass and a hand drill to get this fire going.
Leave that fire go for 1.5-2 hours and it'll be ready for the rabbit. Look at those coals down there. That's hot. Too hot. Let it die down a little bit.
Okay, here's the snowshoe hare. Because I want it to taste really good, I'm adding salt and pepper. And to complement it, I got corn on the cob soaked in water, and I'm gonna wrap it with collard leaves. Oh, and I'm gonna add an onion too. So I'm just gonna drop it in there on those hot coals and just hope for the best. Start putting sticks across the hole, holding the heat to lay the bark on top. I can smell it cooking. Here I'm using a piece of bark as a shovel. Okay, it's been in there for about an hour now, and I want to see how it turned out. I was having a hard time getting it out of the hole. this corn. It's just a little bit burnt right there. Take off the dried out burnt leaves off the hare. Wow. Mmm. You can see the leg there steaming. A little bit sandy. But turned out pretty good. Flavor's pretty good. A little bit undercooked. I could have left it in there for like half hour, 45 minutes more. But, yeah, you know, if you're got a lot of time on your hands, you know you're going to be out in the woods for a long time, it's definitely worth making one of these. Wow, this is really a great way to cook corn. Because it's got these leaves to protect it and keep the sand off it and everything, and it tastes kind of like the fire. You can taste the fire in it a little bit. Roasted, yeah. Just need to leave it in there for about 2 hours, I would say, just to make sure. Other than that, I was on track. I'm Driftwood George. Thanks for watching this little experiment of mine, and I'll get back to you with another interesting video as soon as I can. Thanks, guys.